हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन होस्ट पैथोजन इंटरेक्शन पार्ट फर्स्ट। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर राजेंद्र बालासाहेब काकड़े, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, स्वामी विवेकानंद सीनियर कॉलेज मंठा, डिस्ट्रिक्ट जालना। फ्रेंड्स, द होस्ट पैथोजन इंटरेक्शन, व्हाट इट एग्जैक्ट मीन्स, it is defined as how microbes or viruses, deliberately microbes is separated from the viruses because the viruses are non-living entity when it is outside the host. That's why it is not written under the microbes or the viruses written separate word. Host pathogen interaction defined as how microbes or viruses sustain themselves within host organisms on a molecular, cellular, organismal or population level. Then why one should study the host pathogen interaction? What is its significance? The host pathogen interaction that provide the information which will help to scientists and researchers to understand disease pathogenesis, the biology of one or many pathogens, as well as the biology of the host. Plant microbe interaction. Plants are constantly encountered by both biotic as well as abiotic stresses or factors. There is constant war between the pathogenic microbes and the host plant, and as the outcome of which that will determine the resistance or development of the disease into the host plant. Plant secretes various organic compounds that results in nutritionally enriched environment which will be favorable for microbial growth, and ultimately the secretion of these various organic compounds, plants are heavily colonized with a diversity of microbes whose reservoir is primarily the soil. Microbes that colonize the plants are called either epiphytes. That means microbes which colonize on the plant surface are called as epiphytes, or endophytes, microbes which colonize into the plant or interior of the plant are called as endophytes. Microbial communities influence plants direct or indirect ways. Plants and microbes can have variety of interactions, including pathogenic, symbiotic or associative. Some microbes that interact with the plants may cause disease that are called as pathogens, or term called as pathogenic. Some microbes may reside into the plant roots or beneficial to the plants. Such plant pathogens, not actually they are called as pathogens, such microbes are called as symbiotic microbes. In the symbiotic relationship, both the partners get equal benefit from each other. There are some microbes which resides into the plant cell, such as nitrogen fixing bacteria, which resides into the root nodules and they fix the atmospheric nitrogen. That's why such microbes are symbiotic one. Or some microbes are closely associated with the host. Then pathogenic relationship, the extracellular space between the cell wall and plasma membrane act as a battlefield. The extracellular space, that means the space between cell wall and plasma membrane, is called as apoplastic space. And that apoplastic space is actually the first battlefield between the plants and the pathogen. Pathogens like bacteria, fungi, viruses that colonize the living plant tissues are in cascade in this narrow region in the initial step of infection. In the initial steps of infection, all the microbes or pathogenic microbes reside into this apoplastic region. Therefore, this region is an interface which mediates the first crosstalk between the host and pathogen. In this region, the first meeting of this host and pathogen is there. The secreted proteins and other metabolites derive from the both host and pathogen. In this interaction between the host and pathogen, both the host as well as pathogen secrete their metabolites, and these metabolites, with the help of these metabolites, host and pathogen interact in this apoplastic region and govern the final relationship between them, whether it may be pathogenic, whether it may be symbiotic, or maybe associated. Depending on the effect of these pathogens, there are three types of pathogens: necrotrophic pathogen that directly kill to the host cell, biotrophic pathogen. In the association of this biotrophic pathogen, the plant cell remain alive. Hemibiotrophic pathogen. In this hemibiotrophic pathogen association, the host cell initially alive, but later on it will get killed. Then host pathogen interaction, which will be studied into two parts. In this video tutorial, I am going to focus on this defense mechanism in plants, and in my next video I will discuss on the disease development in plant. So the host pathogen interaction, first we will see in this video defense mechanism in plant. Plant defense mechanism, that may be structural or biochemical. Plant have such system, structural system as well as biochemical system, of with the help of which the plant can defense itself. As far as structural defense mechanism is concerned, there are again two types: pre-existing defense structure, the structure which are already present into the host, plant host, and defense structure developed after the attack of pathogen. Some structures that will develop after the attack of the pathogen. Then let's come toward the biochemical defense mechanism of the host plant. Again, there are two types: pre-existing biochemical defense. There are some biochemical entities which are already present into the plant cell, but apart from this, there are some biochemical entities which are developed after the infection of the pathogen, and such mechanism is post-infection biochemical defense. Let's see one by one. Structural defense, as we already discussed, plants already have structures that defend the host from the attack of the pathogen. On the other hand, some structures that develop after the infection. In this way, two types: first, pre-existing defense structure; second, or B, defense structure developed after the attack of the pathogen. First, pre-existing defense structure. There is presence of cuticular wax, cuticle thickness, structure of epidermal cell wall, that all we will discuss one by one. First, cuticular wax. Wax mixture of aliphatic compounds. The presence of wax is the mixture of aliphatic compounds deposited on the cuticular surface, which is tough to play defensive role by forming hydrophobic surface. Hydrophobic surface, hydrophobic means water hitting surface. That means water will not reside on that surface. That surface is called a hydrophobic surface. And due to presence of this hydrophobic surface, the pathogen does not get sufficient water to germinate or multiply. And due to the scarcity of this water, the pathogen become dead. The fatty acid nature of the wax reduces the chance of infection by many pathogens. The next, cuticle thickness. The cuticle thickness also, that cuticle is present on the leaf surface, that obstruct or disturb the path of the pathogen or disturb the life cycle of the pathogen. The next, third, structure of epidermal cell wall. Here we can see the structure of epidermal cell wall. The epidermal cell wall is already thick in nature, and it's also have the deposition of silica layer. The tough and thick outer wall of epidermal cell directly prevent the entry of the pathogen. Here we can see the fungal spore. Though it is germinating, but the germ tube, it is not yet entry into this epidermal cell due to the presence of this thick wall of epidermal cell as well as the thickening of silica layer. The presence or absence of salicylic acid in the cell wall show variation in resistance to penetration to pathogen. Rice plant epidermal cells have silica layer. Here we can see the silica layer, which is seldomly penetrated by the pathogen. Here we can see the presence of this cuticle layer, and due to this cuticle layer, pathogen entry get restricted. Then structure of natural opening. As we know, there are two natural opening, the stomata and lenticels. In some citrus variety have small and narrow opening of stomata that restrict the entry of the citrus canker bacterium. Citrus canker is caused by Xanthomonas campestris bacteria, and due to presence of the small size of the stomatal pore actually have the gardening of two guard cells, and the thickening of these two guard cell decide the infection or entry of the pathogen bacteria, that is Xanthomonas. Then some apple varieties which have small lenticels prevent the entry of pathogen. Here we can see the lenticel that is actually developed from the cork cambium. Here we can see the lenticel, and on the stem here we can see the white colored lenticel protruding of this lenticel from the epidermal cells of the plant. Some apple varieties which have small lenticels prevent the entry of pathogen, while those having large opening easily allow the pathogen to enter. Means if the lenticels are present, the opening of lenticels have the big size, then from that big size the pathogen get entry. And if the opening of lenticel is small, pathogen does not get entry into the host cell. Here we can see in this figure different methods of penetration and invasion by the fungi. Direct penetration, the fungal spore produces the hosteria. Hosteria is a knob-like structure that absorbs the nutrition from the plant. Then the spore also produces the germ tube to the host cell or tissue. Then spore direct produces mycelium hypha to the host cell, as well as mycelium with the hosteria, the pathogen get flourish into the host tissue. Then penetration through the natural opening, as we already discussed, there are two natural openings, stomata and lenticel. From this natural opening, the pathogen get entry into the host cell. Then hadathodes, these are the glands actually present at the margin of the leaf. From this hadathode gland, the spores of the pathogen also get into the host cell through the water droplets. Then penetration through the natural wounds. Here we can see in this figure, from the wounds, the pathogen get flourish into the host cell. Then through the natural crack between the main and lateral roots. Here we can see. Then fungus kills and macerates cell ahead of its advance. Means fungi secretes, or fungal spore secretes some metabolites that will destruct the host cell, and pathogen get entry into the host. The next, the defense structure developed after the attack of the pathogen. Up till now, we discussed the defense mechanism into the plant, which are already present into the plant. But we will now discuss on the defense structure that will develop after the attack of the pathogen. Defense reaction in cytoplasm. The cytoplasm of the invaded cell surround the hyphae of the pathogen, and nucleus of the host cell get stretched to break into two. In some cell cytoplasm, and nucleus of the infected cell get enlarged. Cytoplasm become granular and dense. This causes disintegration of the pathogen mycelium, and hence invasion stops. It can be seen in big pathogen like armillaria and some mycorrhizal fungi. Then next, cell wall defense structure. Cell wall thicken in response of pathogen by producing cellulose material, thus preventing the entry of pathogen. If the plant cell produces the maximum amount of the cellulose material, that enhances the thickness of the cell wall, and due to the thickness of this cell wall, the entry of the pathogen get restricted. Then amorphous fibrillar material that is developed by outer cell wall of parenchyma cells that trap the bacteria and stop its multiplication. Then callus papillae deposited on inner cell wall. These papillae with phenolics forming sheath around the hyphae. Here we can see there is a formation of sheath. This violet color sheath is developed due to the papillae along with the phenolic compounds, and this encapsulating or forming the envelope around this fungal hypha. Here we can also see this is a fungal hypha and there is a development of this envelope around this hypha. The next defense structure developed by tissues. First, gum deposition. Plant produce variety of gummy substances around the lesions or spots due to the infection. Here into the in this anatomical picture we can see the gum barrier is developed that will restrict the further flourishing of this mycelium. Here we can see already the mycelium are present into the vessel, but the mycelium entry is further stopped at this region due to the gum barrier. Then abscission layer, formation of abscission layer. Here we can see this is the infected portion of the leaf and this is a healthy portion of the leaf. Palisade and spongy cells means mesophyll cells. These are the healthy mesophyll cells and these are the infected mesophyll cells due to the pathogen, and there is a formation of abscission layer. Normally abscission layer is formed during the old or ripened fruit or old leaf, but in this defense mechanism plant have the ability to develop the abscission layer into the leaf as well as fruit also. Then development of the tyloses. Tyloses are actually the outgrowth. Here we can see the tyloses. This is a vertical section. Vertical section. Here we can see development of the tyloses. And this is a transverse section. Development of tyloses into the vessels of the xylem. These are the actually the outgrowth of the protoplast of adjacent living parenchyma cell protruding into the xylem vessels through pits under stress or in response to the attack by the vascular pathogen. Due to the attack of this vascular pathogen, the parenchyma cell produces the tyloses and that tyloses protrudes into the xylem vessels. Tyloses formation blocks the xylem vessels, obstructing the flow of water and result into wilting of symptoms. We can easily observe this type of tyloses development into the wilting of tooth. In wilting of tooth, that is caused due to the fusarium pathogen. Then formation of layers. Here we can see the formation of cork layer by the epidermis, and that cork layer restricts the entry of this fungal mycelium into the healthy cells of the host. Here we can easily see the rhizoctonia infection onto the potato tuber. Then formation of necrosis. In this defense, host nucleus moves towards the pathogen when pathogen comes in contact with the host pathogen. When this pathogen comes in contact with the host, at that time the nucleus of the host come in close contact with the pathogen. Nucleus of the host disintegrate and turns into the brown granules which accumulates around the pathogen, later on dispersing throughout the host cytoplasm. Cell membrane swells and finally cell bursts and dies. This leads to the disintegration of the pathogen nucleus into the homologous mass and cytoplasm becomes dense. Here we can see there is a development of brown colored spots onto the leaf surface. This is occur due to the response of the host cell after the attack of the pathogen. And due to this formation of such types of signs on this leaf, the further entry or further spreading of this pathogen get restricted. Here we can see the remaining area is green colored. After the discussing of the structural the defense mechanism. We will discuss the biochemical defense mechanism into the plant. There are two biochemical defense mechanism: pre-existing biochemical defense mechanism and post-infection biochemical defense mechanism. We will see one by one pre-existing biochemical defense mechanism. First, inhibitors released in pre-penetration stage. Plant exudes organic substances through above ground part that are called as phyllosphere and roots that are called as rhizosphere. For example, fungistatic chemicals released by tomato and sugar beet prevent the germination of botrytis and cercospora. Here we can see the development of this botrytis. The phenolics like protocatechoic acid and catechol in scale of red onion inhibit the germination of Polyotrichum cercinans on red onion surface. Here the pathogen get flourished due to the host is not responded positively towards the pathogen and host does not develop the defense mechanism. That's why pathogen get flourished here. Yeah, it is development of Polyotrichum cercinans on the red onion. And then presence of several phenolics, tannins and some fatty acids like compounds such as dienes in cells of young fruits, leaves or seeds afford them resistance to the botrytis. Here is the structure of saponin and tomatin. Several other compounds like saponin and tomatin in tomato and avenacin in oats have antifungal activity. Due to presence of this saponin and tomatin, the tomato show the antifungal activity. The chitinase enzyme secreted by the host cell degraded cell wall of fungi. The lack of nutrients essential for the pathogen. If the into the host there is no nutrients, then the pathogen flourishing or pathogen development will get stopped. The plant variety or species which do not produce any of the chemical essential for the growth of the pathogen that act as a resistant variety. For example, a substance present in seedling variety susceptible to Rhizoctonia initiating hyphae, cushion formation from which the fungus sent penetration hyphae. From this cushion, the fungus sent penetration hyphae inside the host plant. When this substance is not present, then hyphal cushion are not formed and the infection does not occur. The next biochemical defense mechanism, absence of common antigen into the host. Here we can see there is a absence of common antigen into the host. Presence of common antigen in both pathogen and host plant determines the disease occurrence in the host plant. But antigen present in the host and absent in the pathogen and vice versa, it makes the host resistant to the pathogen. For example, linseed variety have the common antigen with pathogen is susceptible to disease rust. Here we can see the linseed and its pathogen, that is Mellum spora lini, have the common antigen. That's why there is development of the rust symptom on to the whole plant of this linseed. On the contrast, presence of antigen into the linseed variety only will resistance to the pathogen. Next, post-infection biochemical defense means the biochemicals or metabolites which are produced by the host after the infection of the pathogen. First, phenolic compounds. Synthesis of phenolic compounds take place through acetic acid pathway or shikimic acid pathway. Some common phenolic compounds toxic to pathogens are chlorogenic acid, caffeic acid and ferulic acid. Some host produces the phenolic compounds. Here examples are given: chlorogenic acid, caffeic acid and ferulic acid. Due to presence of this phenolic compound, the pathogen will not get developed. These phenolic compounds are produced at much higher rate in resistant variety than the susceptible variety. The disease resistant capacity of some variety is developed due to this presence of these phenolic compounds. Then phytoallergens. First time scientists Muller and Borger in 1940 used this term phytoallergen. These phytoallergens are produced at de novo in plant. De novo means at initial stage of the plant, that is de novo stage of the plants. That phytoallergens are produced in response to the any kind of injury into the host or entry of the infectious agent or the infectious agent products and physiological stimuli. These phytoallergens are produced in cases such as any kind of injury, infectious agents or infectious agents products or any physiological stimuli. All phytoallergens are lipophilic compounds and were first detected after the study of late blight of potato. When the scientists studied this late blight of potato, they observed the production of these phytoallergens. Metabolites of the host plant interact with the specific receptors of the pathogens. Receptors are present on the pathogen as well as the host cell. Metabolites of the host plant interact with specific receptors of the pathogen's membrane, that resulting in the secretion of the phytoallergen elicitors. Phytoallergens are considered to stop growth of the pathogen. How? By altering the plasma membrane and inhibiting the oxidative phosphorylation. These phytoallergens change the plasma membrane of the pathogen. In bacteria, there is presence of plasma membrane. In fungi, there is also presence of plasma membrane. And when this pathogen attack on the host plant, at that time, biochemical defense mechanism is evoked by the plant, and through this mechanism, this host secretes the phytoallergen. That phytoallergen change or alter the structure of plasma membrane of the pathogen and also inhibit the oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative phosphorylation means synthesis of ATP. ATP are the energy currency. And due to this inhibition of the oxidative phosphorylation, that pathogen does not produce energy currency, that is ATP, and that's why they get died. These are the identified in wide variety. These phytoallergens are identified in the wide varieties of soybean, potato, sweet potato, barley, carrot, and cotton. This is the structure of phytoallergen. And examples are given here. Apomemorin, which is secreted by the host Apomea batata in response of the pathogen Ceratocystis imbriata. Then next phytoallergen, Ocrenicol, produced by the host Orchid mellitus. This Orchid mellitus host produce this phytoallergen in response of Rhizoctonia repens. There are several examples are given here. Then substances produced in the host to resist enzyme produced by the pathogens. There are certain substances which are produced by the host to restrict or to inhibit the enzyme produced by the host, pathogen. Some host produce chemicals that neutralize the enzyme produced by the pathogen, thus defending the host. By the production of some chemicals by the host neutralize the enzyme produced by the pathogen and defend itself. In bean plants, infection with Rhizoctonia solanica causes necrosis. Here is a bean plant. The infection of Rhizoctonia solanica onto these seedlings. Here we can see seedlings, development of necrotic spots on the seedling of bean plant due to the Rhizoctonia solanica. But this is a susceptible variety actually. But in some resistant varieties of the bean, the entry of pathogen causes separation of methyl group from the methylated peptic substances and forms polyvalent cations of peptic salt which contain the calcium. And due to presence of this calcium ions, due to accumulation of this calcium ion into the infected as well as neighboring healthy tissues, therefore pathogen fails disintegrate middle lamella. This middle lamella actually present in between the two cells. by its polygalactourinase enzyme. Due to accumulation of these calcium ions into the healthy as well as the infected host tissue, the pathogen that secrete the polygalactourinase enzyme, that polygalactourinase enzyme get neutralized due to accumulation of this calcium ion. And due to neutralization of this polygalactourinase enzyme, pathogen get die. The next, detoxification of pathogen toxins and enzymes. In some cases, plant produce such chemicals that detoxify toxins and enzymes of pathogen. Example are given here, Pyricularia oryzae that causes blood disease in rice. Here, pathogen Pyricularia structure, and this Pyricularia causes blood disease into the rice plant. This is a leaf of the rice plant. Here we can see development of the blast disease onto the leaf. But some resistant variety of the rice plant that convert these toxins, that is picolinic acid and pyricularin toxin that is secreted by Pyricularia. Some resistance variety of rice that convert this toxin into N-methyl picolinic acid and other substances. Toxin like fusaric acid secreted by the wilt pathogen of cotton and tomato, fusaric acid which is converted into non-toxic N-methyl fusaric acid. The pathogen fusarium, which actually causes the wilt into the cotton and tomato plant by the secretion of fusaric acid. That fusaric acid get neutralized by secretion of non-toxic N-methyl fusaric acid by the host cell, or conversion of this fusaric acid into the non-toxic N-methyl fusaric acid, and further infection of the wilting get stopped. Similarly, toxic enzymes of the pathogen are detoxified by phenolic compounds of the host. Pectinolytic enzyme produced by pathogens Sclerotia fructigena on cedar apple host is inactivated by phenolic oxidation products. Then biochemical alterations due to infection of pathogens brings biochemical changes into the host. As soon as pathogens infected to the host, host bring itself biochemical changes which are toxic to the pathogenic microbes, and that causes resistance to the pathogen. There are new enzymes and other compounds are produced and accumulated in higher concentration into the host. This also brings the resistance into the plant host. Thank you for your attention. Please do like and subscribe my YouTube channel, Dr. Rajendra Kakde, and please press bell icon to get notification of new video. Thank you very much.